Okay, now in this video, I'm going to put some bungee into the end of what is my would be my spinnaker tack line. So I use 5mm XL racing line for this. So I'm going to just get a good end on the cut. And then I'm going to singe the end here a little bit. I just don't want this all coming apart. On the other hand, I don't want a big gob of hard plastic on the end here either. So just lightly singe it. Crimp that down a little bit while it's still warm. Now I'm going to pull a core out of a couple inches of this line. Just the first couple inches, maybe like 1.5 to 2 inches. Okay, let's pull it back. Okay, up there. Cut it off here. Okay, so now I have the core cut off. I'm going to pull the cover back. So I use this on the your spinnaker tack line. It's tied out to the end of the spinnaker pole. And then what takes up the looseness on the other end of the line, the slack end of the line, I have a bungee that runs underneath my tramp, but it runs through a couple pulleys, and I don't want those any knots or anything there that would hang up on those pulleys. So I splice some bungee into it. Now normally I use a little bit bigger bungee than this, but I don't have any handy right now. I should have some on order. I'll just use this for now. And it would easily fit another size in here. You can see that's really loose. It fits in there very well. Next size will fit in here also. So I just go up to where that core is out. Just a couple inches is all you need here. Come out the side. Now, when you come out the side of this cover, it's a very tight weave. So just work to fit a little bit. Give it some time. It'll get through there. So now make sure you got enough pushed up in here, and then just pull the fit right through. Okay, pull the line out. Now you got the bungee in there. Now just pull this back just until it's inside there. Okay, now I don't want it to come out any further than that. Now I'm going to take some whipping twine and a needle here and just run a few stitches, 4 or 5 stitches, right through the bungee here, through the cover and through the bungee. This goes through the bungee kind of hard, so I just flip this upside down like this and then push that needle through using the cutting board, the plastic on the cutting board, just to help push it through there. Well, I got a knot in the end of this line here. As you can see, I got one longer, so we got to make sure you pull that there, pull that loop down. I'm just going to pull that knot so it's inside the cover here. Not and pull it right through. Just get it so it's inside the cover. You don't really want it sticking out there. We'll cut those tails off later. Okay, now I'm just going to go back and forth through here a couple times. Each time I'll use the board to help me push it through. It's pretty tough stuff that bungee is. Fingers are pretty beat up and dried out. It's winter here. Not an easy time of the year. And my hands. I'll push up again. That's what, 3 times I went through. There's 4. There's 5. There we go. Okay. Now, I don't want the end of this to fuzz out on here, so what I'm going to do, let's go through one more time. We can get a little closer to the end before, then we'll just whip the end to keep it all captured so it just doesn't turn into a fuzzy mess. So I'm going to come through. There we go. One more time. Okay, now I'm just going to start going around here to capture the end of this line here so it doesn't turn into a fuzzy mess on me here after you use it for a while. Okay, go around 4 or 5 times, and then I go back through the line again with the needle. Try to come out right next to it, come out right next to the thread I already have on there. keeps it pulled up tight. Go around, you know what I mean, nothing has to be perfect about this. Okay, just make sure I don't have any. There we go. Well, that'll keep that end from fuzzing out. And it's a nice smooth transition from the bungee to the 5mm. Now to finish this off, I'm just gonna run, tuck this, go back in here. Just slide it up underneath here and go back through the line. Just got a little bit of the bungee here. Okay. Coming through. It's hard to get a hold of that needle. Once in a while, even grab that with a pliers. Of course, you're gonna start grabbing the needle with a pliers, you know, you're gonna scratch it up and eventually it won't go through there very easy at all. So I try not to use them, but I have. And of course, needles are pretty cheap. You can always buy some more. So I'm just gonna go through, I'm gonna back up from where I went through last time and go through one more time. I'm just going through the cover here now. And then I'll just cut these tails off, and that'll stay like that for a long time. So obviously that's, you know, very strong there. It isn't going to come out. The bungee would break first. So it's a way to make a nice transition on the end of a line. I've seen, you know, there's other ways you can probably accomplish this, but this just makes a nice smooth transition that'll flow through a pulley very easily. Thanks for watching.